So this is very interesting. Like, some of the people and our viewers have asked this question, and I'm going to club things into one so that we can reply in a one big set and have a discussion on this. There is something called Das, Dasyu, or Rakshas, and it is both in Vedas and Manusmriti. I think I can quote around 80 mantras from Vedas where Das, Dasyu is mentioned, and it clearly says kill them or treat them badly or destroy them and all that stuff in both the books. Moreover, like labor class people, so Das, Dasyu, labor class people in modern day society, or Rakshas, does Vedas talk in a negative connotation, or they punish such people? What are your views on that?
Maybe let Dr. Chandra answer it, and then I'll try to find some mantras so that we can talk on them.
See, this is the classification of the people depending on their acts in the society. The Dasyu is the one who gives a bad service or a disservice to the society. For example, antisocial acts, stealing, looting, robbery, murder, atrocities, evil acts are done by the Dasyus. So that's a title. Then similarly, Rakshas. Rakshas is another title in which a person is wicked, who kills or destroys the things for no reason, such as Ravan was a Rakshas, but he was the grandson of Pulakshya Rishi. Then there are other terminologies such as Asur. Asur comes for a person who is ignorant, who is not a knowledgeable, who is not a scholar. So these are the basic definitions which are described, and for that there are punishment to these people is referred, not an ordinary person, because these people have done certain acts which are destructive, and hence how to deal with these people, that's what the topic is.
So Dr. Chandora, like I think it was in news I was watching, and they were showing that in India somewhere people have started worshipping Mahishasur, and they consider him as a god, and they think they belong to the same caste or section of the society. Like, what is that going on related to Mahishasur? Was he a Rakshas or a saint or what?
See, I cannot continue to talk.
Okay, no problem. So, Vishwajit, you want to...
I'll cover some of that. I was trying to find a couple of relevant mantras that I can quote when I'm talking. So, I'm almost done. Give me just a couple of more seconds.
No problem. So, what I will do by that time, basically, I also collected some material.
Awesome.
Yeah. See? So, viewers, regarding Aryan invasion theory, so in India, like, I was one of my friends from Tamil Nadu in my office. He still believes that they are Dravidians and we are Aryans. In spite of my best effort to explain him and providing material, the people don't accept these things. There is something wrong with our people. They don't want to listen and they don't want to read. So what is the solution for that? I think this is where the whole society has to think. Anyway, coming back to Rig Veda 1.51.8. Aryas are those who are religious minded, learned and noble, while Asura or Das are those who are wicked, irreligious and ignorant. So come on, my friends, if you call yourself Das, are you wicked, irreligious and intolerant? Are you going to create a disturbance in the society? Let me quote from P.T. Srinivasan, a well-known South Indian scholar, in his book Dravidian Studies, that the difference between the Aryas and the Dasyus is not racial, out based on their respective qualities, action and temperament. So this is not from us. It is not from northern part of India. It is the South Indian basically scholar who is mentioning this thing. He writes that Aryas and the Dasyus or Dasas referred to not an indicating different races. The word referred not to race but to a cult. So imagine, take example of ISIS, right? They are, you can call them Dasyu and Rakshas, because they are basically destroying the part of the society or creating a disturbance in the society. That is what Dasyu and Dasa is. Similarly, Dr. Mute, I think Dr. Chandora referred to him, is a Western scholar who has written quite a lot on Aryas, Dasyus or Dravidians. So my friends, Dravidians, just I want to enlighten to the viewers. Basically, the South Indian languages, if you say take a group of languages like Tamil, Malayalam, Kannarese and Telugu, combine them together, they form a Dravidian part. So it is basically a group of languages, people speaking those languages, they were referred to as Dravid. Dr. Muir, who is a Western scholar, he himself says, and he has written a lot on Aryas and Dasyus. In his original text, I'll quote volume 2, page 387, writes, I have gone over the names of Dasyu or Asuras mentioned in the Rigveda with the view of discovering whether any of them could be regarded as of non-Aryan or indigenous origin. But I have not observed anything that may appear to be of that nature or character. German scholar Max Müller writes about Dasyus. Dasyu simply means enemy. For instance, Indra is praised because he destroyed the Dasyu and protected the Aryan color. At another place, writing about Matudhan and Rakshas, he writes, they are too general to allow us the inference of any etymological construction. Anyway, coming back, I'll just quote a Sanskrit dictionary. I think it is from Roth. Yeah, he says, it is but seldom, if at all, that the explanation of Dasyu as referring to the non-Aryans, the barbarian, is advisable.
Yeah.
So come on, friends, it's not Hindus or the Arya Samajis or Indians who are saying that. In case if you believe on Dr. Muir or Griffith or anyone, or Western scholars, Roth, they are saying that what Dasyu basically means, or a Rakshas, is a wicked person. Now, who is going to worship Mahishasur, who was, let's say, a Dasyu or a Rakshas,
yes,
right?
I mean, you know.
Go ahead, Vishwaji, I pass
so,
it to you.
So, I think both of you have covered a lot, but what I'll try to do is, I'll try to attach some of the Ved mantras or Sanskrit words with that, just to give a little more authenticity, right? So, for Nirukta, the meaning of Dasyu is Dasyate Karman, one who destroys karma, that you have mentioned, right? So, it refers to an evil person who creates disturbance in society. So, Dasu Upakshaye, made of Dasu Dhatu, that means to get weak, and then weakens the society and nation, and after weakening, merges in himself, takes control and enslaves.
Right.
So there's a differentiation between Dasyu and Das. Dasyu is the person who is actually trying to take the control, and Das is who is actually impacted by that Dasyu and who is getting enslaved.
Right.
So Dasyu is the opposite of the Arya. Arya and Dasyu. So in the Ved, you know, the good people or bad people, Dev or Asur, Arya and Dasyu. So they have used, it's opposite of Arya. And in one of the Rig Veda mantra, it says 1.17.3 that I have opened, and I'll explain this. It says, Reshim Naravanghasaha Panchajanyam Abri Sadatrim Munchatogarena Minanta Dasyo Rashivasya Maya Anupurvam Vrishanacho Dayanta. So the word used for Dasyu here is Ashivasya, who creates trouble and causes misery. And in Rig Veda 4.16.9, they are referring to Dasyu as Achha Kavim Nimanoga Abhishto Swarshata Maghavanna Dhamanam Uti Bhistamishano Dindahuto Ni Mayavana Brahma Dasyu Rata. In this mantra, Dasyu has been described as Mayavan Abrahma Dasyu, who indulges in deception and self-deception, who has no faith in the teachings of the Vedas and who is narrow-minded. So, Vedas are trying to clearly define the difference between Arya and Dasyu. Arya is what? Ishwar Putra, follower of the Vedas. Dasyu is the person who is not the follower of the Vedic teaching. He is living for himself and trying to enslave people. I think that gives a clear definition of Das, Dasyu versus Arya, right? So, yeah, I wanted to definitely quote these mantras. Yeah.
Great. I think that was a great reply from Vishwaji. Just to complete onto this topic, there is a Western scholar, Nesfield, in his book, Brief View of the Caste System of the Northwest Province and Awadh, he has clearly written, there is no division of the people as the Aryan conqueror of India and the aborigines of the country. That division is modern, and that there is essential unity of the Indian races. The great majority of the Brahmins are not of lighter complexion or of finer or better red feature than any other caste or distinct in race and blood from the scavengers who swept the roads. So with that said, my friends, Das, Dasyu, Rakshas belongs to evil person in any corner of the world. It doesn't matter India, America or Britain. Remember, we all are Aryans, and it is our duty to basically Arya. It is our duty basically to punish, or I can say up to a level of destroy, in case if Das, Dasyu or Rakshas are creating harm to the society. Anything else you want to add?
No, I think we are good. Only one thing, that when we talk about destroy or punish, every time, you know, I'll probably bring that in the later questions that you may have or topics. Is the subject of Indra. Indra means Raja. Right. So giving the punishment and identifying the punishment has to be done to bring the harmony or peace back in the society, but it has to be happening by the Raja, who is entitled for that purpose. Okay. Not that terrorists, okay, I say, okay, if I don't punish these people, I'm not punishing kafirs and all that stuff. So that does not, the Veda does not support. Veda says the person who is accountable for a particular job, he or she needs to do that. Not everyone can take the gun and shoot anyone
law and order to be maintained.
But nowadays, if you see in the society, it is very difficult to find such kind of rulers. They used to exist, but now they don't. So I will say it is the responsibility of every person who consider himself or herself as Arya to form a group who can basically form a united force against the evil. I think that is what the world needs today.
Correct.
Individuals, we don't win. As a collective team, we always win. And one of the reason why the world is suffering, because all the bad people are together and the good people are not. So anyway, I think this was a pretty good discussion, and I think there are a couple of mantras like Yajurved 21.3, 21.7, 8.2.19. So they all talk about the labor class people. So what are your views on that, Vishwaji? Like Vedas treat labor class people good?
Well, while I can open the mantra, let me tell one thing.
Yeah, go ahead.
One sentence will cover everything. That mitrasya chakshusha samiksha mahe. Mitrasyaham chakshusha sarvani bhutani samikshe. What I am saying is that I see everyone from an eye of a friend, and everyone sees me as from an eye of a friend. When we say that, friend has no inequality. When I tell you as a friend, that means we are, even though you are doing something different, I may be doing something different. You are a doctor, I am an engineer, my income may be different than yours, but that does not make me lower or upper once I am a friend. Same way, when we talk about Vasudhaiva Kutumbakam, all this universe or earth is my family. In family members, yes, there are elders and youngers and all that stuff, but family is the family. They are all tied together. They work for each other benefits. So there is no question of labor class or hate and anger. And let me give you a couple of mantras from the Yajurved. You mentioned 21.3. Pannu agne varunasya vidvan devasya hiravayasi sishtha yajishtho vannitama shoshu chano vishwa dveshansi pramumugdhyasmat. Which is trying to say that, oh God, take us away from hate and anger. It's a very generic term. Okay? We don't want to have hate and anger for anyone. Then we are talking about in the seventh mantra, suna vamaru heyam asravanti managasam shataritra swastaye. We are saying, let me ride the boat to safety and prosperity. The boat is auspicious, faultless, sinless, and fitted with the 100 oars. So the prayers in the Vedas are not done by keeping a labor class or high class in the mind. They are very generic people, they're generic prayers. And the last one I'll take is 36th chapter. And then he say, I already covered that. Mitra Chakshusha Samiksha Mahe. So my point is that even the kind of job or kind of work that we do, that does not make us a labor or owner or master. Okay? As a human being, we are all equals, similar. We see each other as a friend's eye. So even the mention of the labor class itself is a divisive terminology that has been falsely introduced. So as we said, Shudra is also an Aryan because he's trying to lead a noble path. Only thing is that he could not acquire those skills that a Brahman, Kshatriya or Vaishya could acquire. That does not demean him from anything. He is still a respectable human being, as Dr. Chandora referred from Manusmriti.
Great, great. I think that was a great discussion, and I'm sure the viewers might have received a lot of information. Anything else which Dr. Chandora or Vishwaji you want to say? Otherwise, I will summarize.
I have few thoughts that I have for the followers of Hindu Vedic Dharma, or anyone who wants to create a noble society, anyone who wants to become an Arya or create a noble society. So in the materialistic world, in our day-to-day life, we put a lot of focus on authenticity, accuracy, correctness. We buy something from market, we look for reviews, check the expiry, check the quality, check the specifications. In the other words, we do our due diligence in the spiritual world as well, my friends. I would suggest that before believing on something, know it well. Whether it is logical, truthful, authentic, virtuous or not. If I am believing on something, is it going to kill someone? Is it going to harm someone? That means it may not be right, because we have prayed for everyone's well-being. True knowledge is the biggest asset. I would suggest not bound the righteousness into one sect or so-called religion, Hindu, Muslim, Sikh or Christian. Ved pratipadito dharma, adharmastad viparyaya. Anything that is authenticated and described by the Vedas is dharma, and that is the worth following. And Vedas tell us to become one Arya, one noble person. Once we march towards that nobility, once we try to become that Arya, then we will rise above the divisive agendas and will treat this earth as one family. That does not mean we tolerate falsehood, as I mentioned earlier. We need to counter the falsehood, but not based on personal bias, but on the base of right or wrong per Vedas. As Vedas are our user manual to run this universe. Study of good scriptures like Light of Truth or books like that show us a path to move forward. One must be ready to accept the truth and follow it, and reject untruth. That means stop following it. The segregation of the truth and untruth will come only based on the true knowledge that is our channel trying to provide to you all. Once we diligently identify the righteous path, let's then work towards eradicating falsehood and enhancing the nobility. That's when we can make a peaceful world and that everyone can enjoy. Right. After all, our goal is just not the worldly prosperity, right? Rather than spiritual and social prosperity as well. That's when we lead to the ultimate goal of the salvation, and that's what is, you know, Arya Samaj principles are providing. Arya Samaj that is founded by Maharishi Dhyanananda Saraswati and